Good morning, friends, and welcome to the Morning Tales for July 2nd and 3rd. Today, we will be covering the current affairs for July 2nd and 3rd in this single video, in which we are going to discuss a lot of questions. So, without wasting any time, let's begin our Morning Tales with this first question, that is, what is India's position in terms of money with Swiss Bank according to bank's annual statistics report? So, recently, the Swiss National Bank has released its annual banking statistics report, and in this report, it shows that India is positioned at the 74th place. Now, on which parameter does this report judge countries? So, the parameter of this report is the money which is deposited with the bank. So, in terms of money deposited in the bank, India is at the 74th place. Now, this position is the one position lower than our position in 2018. So, basically in 2018, we were at the 73rd place. Now, another important fact to be noted here is that this report mentions the amount of money deposited with the bank in the year 2018. So if I am saying that it is the year 2019 for which India has 74th rank, so that means that in 2018, the total amount which has been deposited with the bank was considered in this report. So do keep this thing in your mind. So now next important thing about this report is that the amount of money. So how much does India hold with the Swiss bank? So it is the 6,757 crore rupees. So such a big amount that India holds with Swiss bank, but still it is at the 74th position. And the total money which this Swiss bank received from its foreign clients was 1.4 trillion, which is a 4% low amount than it received the previous year. So the overall deposits with the Swiss bank, or the money kept by the foreign clients with Swiss bank, has fallen to 1.4 trillion, which is the 4% fall in the total amount of money deposited with Swiss bank. Now, the other most important thing about this report is that this report mentions that United Kingdom is the top country, and it has a total of 372 billion CHF. CHF is the currency of Swiss. Other important thing that needs attention here is that India's rank among the BRICS country. So, in BRICS countries, that is the group of five nations, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, India has been ranked at the lowest, that is at the 74th position in this rankings by the Swiss bank, and Brazil has been at the 20th position. So this is the overall position of Brazil, and in the group of BRICS, Brazil is the highest money holder in Swiss bank. So that was all about this report. Now let's move on to the next question of today, that is, what is the name of the joint exercise of International Security Alliance? First of all, before answering this question, let us understand this thing, that this exercise was the first ever exercise of International Security Alliance. So the exercise which took place recently was the first edition of the joint exercise between International Security Alliance. So the answer to this question is option A, that is ISALEX-19. So guys, if we bifurcate this name, then it becomes ISALEX-19. So the name of this exercise is the abbreviation of International Security Alliance Exercise 2019, if we want to remember it. And remember this thing, that this was the first edition of this joint military exercise. Now, another important part of this information is that where was this exercise concluded? So the answer to that question is Abu Dhabi, which is in UAE. So remember this thing that the first edition of this joint exercise of International Security Alliance was concluded in Abu Dhabi, UAE. Now, how many countries are part of this International Security Alliance? Do mention your answers in the comment section below. Now let's move on to the next question. Which Prime Minister is appreciated in a Prime Minister to Remember Memories of a Military Chief? A very prominent book it is, and it has been written by the former Navy Chief Sushil Kumar. Now which Prime Minister does this book appreciate? So the answer to this question is Atal Bihari Vajpayee. This book mentions, or rather appreciates, the actions taken by Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And also the other important thing that this book mentions is about Operation Parakram. Now what is this Operation Parakram? So this Operation Parakram was launched after the attack on Indian Parliament in 2001. Now let's move on to the next question of today, that is, what is the name of the helicopter that NASA seeks to launch to Titan to search elements that can sustain life by 2026? Quite important question it is, as NASA is planning to launch a multi-rotor helicopter to the Saturn's largest moon, and that too by the year 2026. So now what is the name of that helicopter? So the name is Dragonfly. So the Dragonfly will be launched in the year 2026 and it will reach the Titan's surface in the year 2034. So do remember this thing, that Dragonfly is the name of the helicopter which NASA is planning to launch. Now let's move on to the next question. Which organization has been chosen for President's Award for Excellent Corporate Social Responsibility 2019? Basically, this President's Award for Excellent Corporate Social Responsibility appreciates the efforts of the organizations towards fulfilling their corporate social responsibility. So now, which company has been awarded with this award for 2019? So it is the NALCO. So NALCO is a Navratna CPSE, that is Central Public Sector Enterprise, which is headquartered in Odisha. And this organization has been awarded with President's Award for Excellent CSR. Two most important things that need to be discussed here. First is that NALCO operates under the Ministry of Mines. And second important fact about NALCO here is that this President's Award has been given to NALCO for its scheme, NALCO Ki Ladli. NALCO Ki Ladli is a scheme initiated by the NALCO to provide education to the girls belonging to below poverty line families, or basically belonging to poor families, which was started in the year 2015. So do remember this thing, that this award has been given to NALCO for NALCO Ki Ladli. Now let's move on to the next question of today. Which company has won the Market Entrant of the Year in UK India Awards 2019? So there are 5 options. It is Mindtree, Oyo, Munch, Zomato, PolicyBazaar.com. So out of these 5 options, it is Oyo that has won the Market Entrant of the Year in UK India Awards. Basically, Oyo has won the UK India Award in the category of Market Entrant of the Year. So now this UK India Awards are very important. Why is this award so much important? Let's discuss those things. First of all, this UK India Award was given to mark the conclusion of annual UK India Week. So after the conclusion of UK India Week, this award was conferred. And do you remember that in one of our previous morning tales, we have discussed about India Day? So this India Day is also a part of this UK India Week. So now, apart from this Market Entrant of the Year award, there are other 3 to 4 very important awards that needs to be discussed here. So let's move on to those awards. So these are the 4 most important awards. So first category is Lifetime Achievement Award, and this award has been conferred upon journalist Mark Tully. And second important category is the Social Impact category, and in this category British Telecom has been awarded. The third category which needs to be discussed here is that Global Indian of the Year. It has been conferred upon Kunal Nair. Now Kunal Nair has played the famous Rajesh Kothrapalli on US show The Big Bang Theory. Now the last, that is Startup of the Year award, and it has been awarded to Munch. So this Munch is a new platform which links the funders, basically the investors and the receivers, in order to promote the global sustainable development. So it is basically a digital platform in order to accelerate or in order to speed up the process of global sustainable development. So that was all about these awards, but now let's move on to the next question of today, that is, who will head the committee formed by Ministry of Telecommunications to review the taxes and to promote ease of doing business in telecom sector? So recently a committee was formed by the Ministry of Telecommunication to review the taxes of the telecom companies. Now why is there any need to set up a committee to review the taxes? So the reason behind setting up a committee is that the telecom sector of India is actually financially stressed. Financially stressed means debt laden, and it is not earning the profits up to the mark. So that is why this committee has been formed, in order to review the taxes as well as to revive the financially stressed telecom sector. This is a very important purpose for forming this committee, that it aims to revive the financially stressed telecom sector. Now who will head this committee? So the answer to this question is option D, that is Aruna Sundararajan. So she will be heading this committee. So now the question for you guys is that, who is the Minister of Telecommunication? do mention your answers in the comment section below. Now let's move on to the next question, that is, in which country has the Mahatma Gandhi Information Technology and Biotechnology Park been inaugurated? So recently a new Mahatma Gandhi Information Technology and Biotechnology Park has been inaugurated to mark the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. And in which country has it been inaugurated? So it is the Ivory Coast, in which this new park has been inaugurated. And in order to build this park, Exim Bank has provided a line of credit of 20 million. Now the other important part about this Mahatma Gandhi IT and Biotechnology Park is that it is a free trade zone which will be built in two phases, where phase one will be built with the help of Shapoorji Company and second phase will be built by United Telecom Limited, which is an Indian company. So do remember this thing, that the Mahatma Gandhi Information and Biotechnology Park was inaugurated in the Western African country of Ivory Coast. Now let's move on to the next question. Very important question it is, so do listen to this question carefully, guys. Now, which state cabinet has approved an amendment to Factories Act 1948 to allow women to work during night shifts? So there are five options: Arunachal Pradesh, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal or Goa. And out of these five options, it is option E, Goa, that has approved the amendment to Factories Act 1948 to allow women workers to work during the night shifts from 7 p.m. to 6 a.m. in industries. Now, what is the purpose behind this amendment? It is quite basic and obvious that it has been done in order to increase the employment opportunities for women as part of the Women Empowerment Initiative. Now, another important part of this question that needs to be discussed here is the Factories Act 1948. So, the Factories Act 1948 supervises the overall well-being of workers at workplace. So, this Factories Act supervises two types of companies: an establishment with 10 or more workers with electricity will be considered a factory and will be supervised under the Factories Act 1948. Now, other part is that, or the other minimum eligibility is the establishments with 20 or more workers but without the usage of electricity will also be considered a factory and will be supervised under the Factories Act 1948. So now let's move on to the next question, that is, who has become the first civil officer to climb the North America's highest peak, Denali, in Alaska? There are five options: Apurva Chaudhary, Aparna Kumar, Shelly Sharma, Arun Singhal, Varun Chaudhary. So out of these five options, it is Aparna Kumar who has become the first civil officer to climb the North America's highest peak, that is Denali. And she has achieved this feat as part of her Seven Summits Challenge. Seven Summits refers to the seven summits of seven continents, and these summits are the highest summits of seven continents, and this challenge refers to the climbing of these seven highest summits in all the seven continents. Now, other important fact about this Aparna Kumar is that she has become the first woman IPS DIG and Indo-Tibetan border officer to achieve this feat. So guys, now can you tell me that what are the other six highest peaks in the world? So do mention your answer in the comment section below. And now let's move on to the other question of today. Who is the writer of the New Delhi Conspiracy? A very important book it is, because this book focuses on the Delhi politics and also on the national political trajectory or national political scenario. So now, who is the writer of this book? So it is Meenakshi Lekhi who has written this book. And apart from her, Krishna Kumar is the co-author of this book. Now let's move on to the next question. Who has been appointed as the Director General of Indian Coast Guard? So there are five options: K. Muthuswamy, K. Harikrishnan, K. Ramgopalachari, K. Natarajan, K. Murugan. So out of these five options, it is option D, that is K. Natarajan, who has been appointed as Director General of Indian Coast Guard. So now guys, the question for you is that, where is the headquarter of Indian Coast Guard? So do mention your answers in the comment section below. And now let's move on to the next question. Who is the chairman of Internet and Mobile Association of India? This man has been recently appointed as the chairman of Internet and Mobile Association of India, and his name is Amit Agarwal. And now it is the time to move on to the last question of today, and that is, who has been appointed as the MD of National Housing Bank? Very important appointment it is. So there are 5 options: Praveen Kumar, Jagan Shetty, Mohan Agarwal, Sarad Kumar Hota and Sharad Patwardhan. So out of these 5 options, it is option D, that is Sharad Kumar Hota. So he has been appointed as the MD of National Housing Bank. So that was all for today. Thank you so much guys for watching our video. And if you have learned anything from the video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much for watching the video.